Yeah, like I said, I'd film some of the process of me bottling. Sorry, I've got a cold. Yeah, here I go.
That's you, Daddy.
Mm-hmm. I'm just rinsing out some of these bottles.
That's Daddy.
That's my daughter in the background.
That's Daddy.
I know this is pretty boring. I'm not really,
That's
Daddy. What I've got there is a pink stain remover that I use, and what I do is I just rinse them out, leave them overnight in the pink stain remover, saves me washing them, and then I put them into just a clean water solution and just shake, and stop shaking them. I just put them on the bottle dryer, or a bottle tree, and then I'll put them in star sand in about just before I'm about to bottle. See you when I start bottle. Yeah, what we got here is hopefully you can see that final gravity, this Belgian Wit. Sorry I didn't film the brew day, but I'm trying to zoom in on that. Not really going to work. Okay, I've got it in at, I think it is around, it is around 1008 is the final gravity. It started out at 1040. Oh, so it'll be a nice sort of light 4.5% beer, I suppose. Around about that. Yeah, this is the Belgian Wit. It's just out of the out of the fermenter. Yeah, it's got a bit of a wheaty sort of nose on it, but it's very green. You can it's winey, you know, winey green. You can't smell any of the Halotau hops in it. When I do the tasting video, I'll put the recipe up. I'm not going to put it up right now, but it's a Sam Adams summer ale clone, but I knocked out the grains of paradise and I put coriander seeds in like most others have. Yeah, it's a really, it's not okay, out of the fermenter, see how it tastes. Mmm, it's dry. Oh, and weedy. A little bit weedy. So put a fair bit of flake weed in there. Mmm. That's nice. It's nice. Alright, this is my next phase of bottling. So I've got my caps and everything in some water. I'm just going to put some star sand in there, and I'm going to sterilize all these bottles. I'll just show you how I do one of them. I'm going to show you how I do all of them. Probably about 10 litres, so probably about a third of that is all that's going to need to get back to get the right pH in it to sanitize that. So yeah, pretty much I'll just make sure that star sand's all in there. Move through, there's my little bottler. I have a cup there, and you'll see what I do later on with the cup. Sorry, I wasn't even looking at it. So I'll put those two in first. Where are you? Where's the other one of those bottles? Where is it? No, it's not it. Where is it? The Matilda Bay one. Yeah, these two Matilda Bay bottles I'm going to do an experiment with, because I had this thing where I bottled with corn sugar, which I normally do, and then after I bottled with the corn sugar, I found that, you know, after bottling with the corn sugar, I wasn't getting the right carbonation levels that I wanted. After a period of time, I would, but I bottled a couple just normal table sugar, and that seemed to work out really good. So, sorry, the lighting's probably really bad inside the house. So what I'm going to do is bottle those two with normal table sugar and see what the carbonation level is with those. All right, so I've sanitized all my bottles and stuff, and now I'm going to do my little experiment. I've got the normal sugar there, my corn sugar there. As you can see, I've got my caps in Starsan. The rest of them are in the Starsan solution up here, and that's what I use that little cup for, bottler, and obviously plastic fermenter. I plan to get some glass fermenters later on, but this is the way that we do it because it's so hot up here. Okay. Alright, so first, let's get my corn sugar. I've just got this little spoon that I use, and I'm not going to show you for all of these, and it just sort of measures out to that much for a 330 milliliter. I don't know what that is in ounces, but 330 milliliter bottle, and I'm going to use the, I don't know whether this will affect the flavour or not, but I found that the other one got better head retention, but it was a very hoppy beer, so I don't know how that really affected the flavour. Okay, so we'll give this a go. If it works, it works. If it doesn't, when I do the tasting, I'll do the tasting out of these bottles. So that'll work it out. All right. You've seen other people bottle before. I'm not going to go ahead and show you exactly. I'll do just one. All right. So all I do is I just turn my tap on full. So I might froth up a little bit, not too much. I just go to about there, and that's it. That's my see that the corn sugar probably froth up a little bit more. And that's pretty much what I do for all of the bottles. And I'll put caps on as I do them. I just put a cap straight on the top like that. That way any headspace in the bottle gets purged with carbon dioxide. It's all good. And then I'll cap them later on. Thanks for watching. See ya.